This week on Cigars, Booze, and Conversation, the one and only Tom Boyd, a.k.a. Mr. Slim. He's going to tell you what he likes, why he does it, and where you can see him doing it at. Sit back and enjoy a conversation with Mr. Slim. This week on Cigars, Booze, and Conversation. This week on I'm a Lifetime Musician, Cigars, Booze, and Conversation, we have local artist, guitarist, vocalist, and rock and roll player, Mr. Slim. I want to thank you for coming out, brother.
My pleasure, Charles.
So we're going to talk to the people and tell them exactly where you came from and so they understand who you are.
Well, born in Philadelphia, grew up 49th in Baltimore. First time I sang in public, I sang for my grandparents' wedding anniversary. I sang the Ave Maria, and it was truly a thrill that I wasn't aware it was going to be so good.
Oh, wow.
It turned out really well.
So you can actually really sing this?
God bless me with the talent.
So how did you learn to play guitar?
I picked it up when I was about 15 to start, bumping around with it, So I just taught myself.
And you taught yourself how to sing and play guitar at the same time, which is some people think it's easy, but not that easy.
Well, I've always been able to sing. If I could open my mouth, I could sing. It's just, you throw my head back. Some of my most favorite things to sing are the gospel things.
Okay.
I do some gospel when I do the senior centers, nursing homes. Some of them are just rousing, just blood moves right to my head. How great that was. Mm. Can you get much better than that?
I understand, I was in gospel for a long time.
Yeah, I started
playing gospel first. So how did you finally put your first band together?
Well, when I went through my first divorce, I was hanging around with all my friends, and the idea popped up while we were sitting around, let's start a band. So it just kind of went from that. We did a lot of covers, we wrote some things. It was basically a real learning experience. I never sang with people before, except the choir, but that's totally a different thing. But singing with other musicians that really had it together, I was learning a lot. I learned a lot. I had a road show that I went on.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I played for a school assembly program, and that was a thrill. Four and five shows a day.
Damn.
Yeah, it was awesome. Five statewide.
Yeah, so
when I got off of that, I had an opportunity to sing for a group that was very popular in the Delaware County, Philly area called the Rockabilly.
Okay.
And so I sang with the Rockabilly. My first gig was the Chestnut Cabaret.
Oh, yeah.
Chestnut Cabaret. We were in Cabaret Circuit, so we played 23 East Cabaret, Yardmore, Boston.
Amber Cabaret.
Amber, yeah.
I was in that circuit for a while. Any other artists you played with that I would know?
Well, we were playing Dobbs one time, and Tommy Conwell sat in with us.
Oh, my boy.
He's the man. He's so enormously talented.
Yeah, he really is. He's good. So you want to tell the people about what you're doing now and how they can get information to book your band or anything?
Sure. Pretty much, I still do senior centers. I do luncheons, solo gigs like that. I very much enjoy doing the Lansdowne Farmers Markets close by me. And they have different artists every week. So I get a chance to play at least once a year, sometimes twice if they have a cancellation. The man knows that he can give me a call. So instead of playing by myself, which I can do, it's fun, but I've pulled a couple different guys together. And the last time we played, I had my friend on piano and another friend on electric guitar, and we just jammed out. We was just like, And then I seen a friend in the audience who called me the harmonica, named Bob Hamilton. He's excellent, and he just sat in at least a half a dozen tunes. It's just a great time.
And Dennis Conlon.
Dennis Conlon's awesome. Yeah, excellent musician.
Well, let me take you out. Let's go.
having some other drinks tonight.
Well, you know, how to contact me on that.
Yeah, that's important.
It's Mr. Slim, that's MR.SLIM, MUSIC, Mr. Slim Music at Yahoo.com.
Cool.
You can call that up and you can get different information. If I have a gig, it'll be listed there. Or you could go to Slim Jim and Big Guy Band. And that's on Facebook and Reverb Nation. Probably put your red on Reverb Nation.
Okay.
So they have songs, you know, and a couple of videos, so you can see the band in action. And if there's any gigs coming up, you'll be able to get a notification there.
Cool. You know, Slim, I really respect your playing and your vocals, man. I really got you on the show, man. So I want to thank you for coming out. And Mr. Slim.
Yes.
This wraps up another episode of Cigars, Booze, and Conversation. We want to thank Tom Boyd, a.k.a. Mr. Slim, for a great interview. In your travels, if you see Mr. Slim on the marquee at your local venue, stop in, check him out. It'll be well worth it. Don't forget, every Sunday, right here on the Darryl Ray Channel, Cigars, Booze, and Conversation. We'll see you next time. Hey, this is Darryl Ray telling you about my new channel on YouTube. If you're looking for incredible, intriguing, and interesting new music content, then subscribe to the Darryl Ray Channel. Here on this channel, our goal is to enlighten the viewer to some unique, soulful, and amazing music. Whether it's rock, pop, blues, or hip-hop, the Darryl Ray Channel is just for you. Like and subscribe.